Nothing compares to the promise that we have in Him. And it's a promise. Glory to God. Now the thing about the pursuit of God is that He has a way of giving promises that come and require that you ignore the reality that is there. And now the thing about the world and the God of this world is He actually comes with things which seem to be quick and there and then. Take it right now, receive it, you know, you don't have to wait here. And then now, God is giving a promise of something which is, you know, which is grander. Now you see that across the world, there's an attempt especially by science, to try and show that all the things that are promised by God can be created by men without the need of God. You've seen that. Apparently, they are bringing people back from the dead. They are prolonging people's lives to hundreds and hundreds of years. It is going to be that way. They are doing all these things to show that you actually do not need God to have eternal life. Praise the Lord. So now they are making the promise of God look more unappealing to people who are not grounded in what they are doing. Okay? Because the things which God promised, imagine you're here believing God for divine health. And then they say, no, there is this thing you can take and you cannot get sick. Your body basically is immune to sickness. And then this one, you cannot die, and then what? And so all the things which God has promised us in the world, they are trying to show that science can replicate them without the need of God. But then, now, that's when we actually have to hold on to the promise of God. Praise the Lord. Because it's purely deceptive, and they can achieve a lot of things, and they will actually achieve a lot of things. But more than anything, they will achieve the issue of taking so many people away from the path of God. You have to believe that actually nothing compares to the promise that He has. If something starts to compare to that promise, then you are in serious trouble in your mind. Praise the Lord.